A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 10th Jan, on the front page you have foreign envoys in Jammu and Kashmir on a fact-finding visit. So we had seen Delhi government had asked envoys in Delhi as such to send an invitation to them to visit Jammu and Kashmir, and now 15-member foreign envoys delegation has arrived in Jammu and Kashmir in Srinagar on a two-day visit. And they have met over 100 people, including senior valley-based politicians, top newspaper editors, and grassroots representatives. And here you have JNU students beaten up during march. So this is at Jawaharlal Nehru University in Delhi. Again, you see several students were beaten up by Delhi police personnel as they tried to march towards Rashtrapati Bhavan after unsatisfactory talks with officials of HRD Ministry. So the HRD Ministry rules out Vice Chancellor's removal after talks with delegation of students and teachers. And here you have Supreme Court rebuffs plea to implement CAA. So CJI Sharad Bobde, he said that the country was already going through difficult times and an endeavor should be made to maintain peace. So we made an oral comment while hearing a petition seeking an aggressive implementation of Citizenship Amendment Act, which fast tracks benefits of citizenship to illegal migrants from Pakistan, Bangladesh, and Afghanistan for six religious minorities from those countries. So on this, he has said that court must independently review the law for elements of unconstitutionality. So this fast track implementation of CAA has not been accepted by Supreme Court, and here you can see. He explained to the lawyer that any law passed by the legislature was anyway attached with a presumption of constitutionality. So it was now for the Supreme Court to independently review the law for elements of unconstitutionality in it. So in the Supreme Court, you have cases favoring the CAA, this one which is calling for quick implementation of Citizenship Amendment Act, which has already been passed by Parliament. And then there are petitions. It says there are over 60 petitions challenging the legality of Citizenship Amendment Act. So that is that. So Supreme Court will decide on this too now. On page 7, you have state to review industrial subsidies in Vidarbha. So the Deputy Chief Minister Ajit Pawar has said that Mahavikas Aghadi government, the coalition government in Maharashtra, will review the subsidies given to select industries in Vidarbha over the last 5 years. So Vidarbha is a stronghold of BJP, and its leadership receives annual power subsidy of 1,200 crore and another 1,000 crore in textile subsidy. So all of this, it is said, will be reconsidered. And below you have declare Goa sanctuaries as tiger reserves. So this is what activists are demanding, and Goa state government, the same must follow the proposal sent to center in 2017. So they want the tiger reserves here as such. So there have been recently 4 tigers who died in Mahadai Wildlife Sanctuary in Goa. So the activists want the sanctuary to be declared as a tiger reserve so that better protection is provided to the tigers. On page 9, you have UP tops list of crimes against women. So this is National Crime Records Bureau, which published its annual Crime in India report 2018, in which it is seen that UP is most unsafe for women. Rate of crimes against women per lakh population is very high. Here you can see. This is rate of total crimes. In that, Assam is high. Assam recorded 166 crimes per 1 lakh women, which is the highest in the country. And this is about suicides also. The number of suicides amongst daily wage earners is quite high. Then come housewives, students, and farmers. So this is the detail of the report which is given here, you can see. In terms of numbers of crimes against women, it is Uttar Pradesh. In terms of concentration, means the number of crimes per 1 lakh women, it is Assam, which tops, followed by Delhi. And here you have panel approved scheme to trade in forests. So the Forest Advisory Committee, which is the apex body tasked with adjudicating requests by the industry to raise forest land for commercial purposes. So this Forest Advisory Committee has now approved a scheme that could allow forests to be traded as a commodity. So Forest Department can outsource one of its responsibilities of reforesting to non-government agencies. So this is the a cause of concern too, which has been raised here. So in current system, industry needs to make good the loss of forest by finding appropriate non-forest land equal to that which would be raised, and it also must pay to the state forest department the current economic equivalent, which is called NPV, net present value of the forest land. So then it is the department's responsibility to grow appropriate vegetation that would eventually become a forest. So industries complain that it is hard for them to acquire appropriate non-forest land, so which is, should be contiguous to the forest region. And it is said nearly 50,000 crore has been collected by the center over decades, but the funds are lying unspent because states were not spending the money on regrowing forests. Supreme Court had also intervened in this matter, and it had also said that money should be dispersed among states, and has been dispersed among states, but states are not using that. So this is green credit scheme which has been proposed, which allows agencies that could be private companies, village forest communities, to identify land and begin growing plantations. And after 3 years, they would be eligible to be considered as compensatory forest land if they meet the required criteria of the department, forest department. So this is the scheme, green credit scheme. So industries would raise forests, and this forest greening would take place through these non-government agencies outsourcing it, because it says states are not doing it. On the editorial page, the first editorial is mining deep. So this is regarding coal mining. So coal mining sector has been opened up, and the conditions, restrictions which were there on end usage also, they have been proposed to be removed. So this editorial says that while opening up coal mining sector, the government must protect the interests of Coal India. So Coal India Limited is the largest organization, largest company in coal sector, and it's a public sector undertaking. So protecting Coal India's interest is highlighted in this editorial. And this is a continent on fire. So this is regarding Australia, where forest fires have been catastrophic in this season. And it says Australia must adopt policies that will foster environment protection. The lead article, a nation losing democratic steam. So it says, beyond the undermining of India's pluralism, Citizenship Amendment Act signals New Delhi's low regard for neighboring countries also. So it is putting accusations on neighboring countries of persecution too. So that is also point raised. It has often been stated that it would strain relations with our neighboring countries too. And this is CDS and the path to joint manship. So this is regarding the new post created, Chief of Defense Staff. General Bipin Rawat has been appointed as the first CDS, and earlier also we have seen how it has been pointed out that this Chief of Defence Staff post is undermining the civilian leadership in case of defence purposes, because another leader has been put up, which is combining the three armed forces. So this says his role is not just about tri-service cooperation, means tri-service is Army, Navy and Air Force. So it's not just tri-service cooperation, but also to ensure that acquisitions do not exceed capital allocations. So defense allocations are done in the budget. So the acquisitions which take place, the whatever is acquired, defense equipments acquired as such, that should not exceed capital allocation. That will also be seen by the Chief of Defense Staff. On op-ed page you have, what is the state of open source in India today? So this is regarding open source movement, which has focused on democratizing technology access. So it has over a 2-decade history in India too, and it is said it is a new normal, open source, but we still need to go a long way to adopt open source tools in big data. So this has been spoken of here. You see, there are many softwares, many, as many here you can see, like it is Wikipedia, Windows Media Player, VLC Media Player. So these are all open source softwares. On page 12, you have Supreme Court to rule on Jammu and Kashmir curbs today. So petitions have been filed which say restrictions are crippling essential services and communication in Jammu and Kashmir. So on this now, Supreme Court ruling would come. And here you have India-Sri Lanka hold productive talks. So this is Sri Lankan minister who was on a visit to India, and he sought support for vocational training and capacity building from India. on international page you have MPs approve Brexit bill, UK set for Jan 31 exit. So British has passed a major milestone on the road to Brexit. The House of Commons has approved a bill authorizing the country's departure from European Union at the end of January, that is Jan 31 2020. So now it will go to the upper house, the House of Lords, the Brexit bill as such. Then on business page you have 60 listed firms disclose 75,000 crore default. So SEBI had asked these companies to disclose loan defaults at the end of every quarter. So now you can see companies have listed their default. So this was SEBI demand from all companies. So here you can see 60 listed firms, and together default is 75,000 crores. And here you have NCLT to consider only government probe on CG power. So National Company Law Tribunal, which is hearing a matter related to restatement of accounts of CG power, has said only a probe by government body would be considered by the tribunal while deciding on the matter. And the matter is allegations of siphoning of funds by the company's former chairman Gautam Thapar. So this is a case before NCLT. That is fine. This is important. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, ashr.com. Thank you.